We're in the Portuguese capital, Lisbon, at the Web Summit, one of the largest tech conferences in Europe. Here, the talk is all about the internet, the possibilities and opportunities of the digital industry, but also its negative side effects.
I'm
delighted to be joined by a European head of government, the Prime Minister of Luxembourg, Xavier Bettel. Prime Minister, thank you for being with us here on Euronews. It's rather surprising to see you here at the Web Summit. How important is the digital industry in Luxembourg? And in what ways are you innovating?
My country may not be very big size-wise, but when it comes to the digital industry, it is in the lead. Whether you look at rankings from Davos or on an international scale, we are always in the top 10, 15 or 20 countries globally. The digital agenda is also a European priority. At the moment, we're a bit trapped between the United States and Asia, and it's important to have a common strategy. And Luxembourg has a true digital presence. 5% of jobs in Luxembourg are in the digital field, and that's just the beginning.
5% des emplois chez moi sont dans le digital et ce n'est qu'un début.
There are still online obstacles that obstruct citizens' access to goods and services. Tell me, what's being done for the European Union's single market to adapt to the digital era? There are still regulatory barriers, so where are we exactly?
There's a lot of talk, but not much is being done. We've been talking about a single digital market for years. I myself have been a member of the Telecom Council for 4 years. There's a lot of talk, but very few results. There are a lot of initiatives, but few legal procedures. If you have a startup and you go to the United States, you're catering to a market of 500 million people regulated by a single set of rules. In Europe, you have 500 million people, but there are 27 or 28 sets of rules just for one small startup. That means having to abide by the rules of each country individually in order to establish yourself and be competitive in these different countries. So it's important to have a common legislation, a common regulator, and I think things are moving forward. But even though the digital world moves fast, I sometimes feel like we are moving at a snail's pace when it comes to common European legislation.
Let's talk about the Paradise Papers revelations that have been in the headlines this week. Were you surprised? What's your reaction?
No, I said it from the start. Tax harmonization is something that is very important for Luxembourg. Not that everyone should be submitted to the same tax rate, but we need to avoid situations where double non-taxation leads to no taxation at all.
My
country today is not the same country it was a few years ago. Today, my country is no longer on any blacklist or grey list with the OECD or anyone else. So Luxembourg believes that what we need to do is to sit together around a table and discuss how to avoid firms not paying any taxes at all. When LuxLeaks happened, everybody said, "Ah, Luxembourg." And then we saw that it was a Europe-wide and a worldwide situation with rulings and laws. And I insist there are laws, but we also need to have morals, which should allow us to say it's not okay to not pay any taxes.
These LuxLeaks revelations were a national trauma. How did people feel during this period?
What happened is that it was legal. And then on the other side, I think, out of respect for the people, simply put, how can I explain to people that someone who earns billions in profits doesn't pay any tax, and that someone who runs a small business pays taxes like everyone else? So what we need is regulation that obliges everyone to pay taxes.
It's true, Luxembourg changed its tax rules last year to outlaw the abusive tax-saving schemes used by multinational firms in your country. But at the same time, there's the feeling that Luxembourg is always putting on the brakes in Brussels.
We're not putting on the brakes at all. We need to stop and think for a minute. Is today's market just a European market or a global market? And more importantly, when you talk about digital, we're at the Web Summit here, whether you agree or not, is it in Europe's interest that companies should pay more taxes in Europe than in the US or in Asia? So I think it's important to develop legislation within the OECD where the United States and other non-European countries share common tax rules.
Tax evasion is a subject that makes people people very angry in Europe and leads to dissatisfaction among citizens. I would like to ask you, after Brexit, Trump, the rise of the far right, populism, Catalonia, why and how have things come to this?
People have questions, people have problems, they have fears, and we tell them that one day we will find solutions. I think people want solutions. I think that today people would like to have a common policy, for example, on immigration, that they would like to see that we are able to manage our borders. I think that after Brexit, people would like to know that Great Britain won't be better off because it chose to leave the European Union. I think people have questions and we need to give them answers. Europe isn't just finance, it's not just an economy, it's first and foremost values, solidarity, and we need to remember that from time to time.
Regarding the Brexit negotiations, it's like a dialogue of the deaf. Recently, you said that the British were being more realistic than half a year ago. What do you mean by that?
6 months ago, it was no deal is better than a bad deal. That was the hard Brexit option.
But you still hear that?
Yes, but less often. You hear it less often in Brussels. There's a convergence between the rhetoric in London and in Brussels compared to 6 months ago. Today, people are willing to sit around a table and find solutions.
How's your relationship with Jean-Claude Juncker?
Very good. Two Luxembourg citizens at the European Council. It doesn't happen every day. Back in the 90s, it was with Jacques Santer and Jean-Claude Juncker, but today, he no longer represents Luxembourg, but Europe. He's the father of the European Commission.
A number of important European figures have come from Luxembourg. Jean-Claude Juncker, Jacques Santer, Gaston Thon. Do you have any European ambitions? You are still one of the youngest prime ministers in Europe.
That's very kind of you to wish me a European career. I am the Prime Minister of Luxembourg until next year's elections, and I hope to extend my mandate. I have a mission. I want to modernize my country. I want my country to be among the front runners in Europe. Today, I see growth, a drop in unemployment, and I want to continue on my mission.
J'ai commencé une mission, j'ai envie de la continuer.
Monsieur le Premier ministre, merci,
merci
beaucoup.
À vous.
C'était une excellente conversation.
À très bientôt.
Très très bonne journée et revenez.
Merci.
Merci.
À bientôt.